Alright guys, welcome back. I tried to do one of these yesterday when I started this project. Well, the second time I started this project of Anime and Riley. And it totally backfired because the screen capturing thing did not work. So, I am starting over. Well, not starting over because I already did a bunch, but I am now gonna do a little more. This is what I did with the other video. Made this hidden move a little. Not much, because it takes forever, but getting back to it now. Hopefully this video goes through, because if it doesn't, I'm not gonna really be looking forward to doing many more videos. And what I'm doing right now is I'm going through and doing a little bit of the animation at a time. So right now I'm on frame 27 pretty much. I got some other pieces like the ears and the head moving, but I saw a complication in my design because right here his head kind of breaks off from his neck, which I might be able to fix with the left side of the coat, but we're gonna see as time goes on. Now for this I'm probably gonna have to hide everything. Let's paste that back. Alright, let's remove it. What happens to his hand here? Looks like his shoulder's just coming up. So, let's see if we can do this cheaply. I'm not really liking that. So what we're gonna do, remove that. Just make it a little darker there. And then we're just gonna straight up draw it again. I have to start using my keyboard shortcuts more. I mean, I know them all, so I don't know why I don't use them. Alright, let's see how that looks. Actually, hold up. Right. I'm gonna steal these buttons. Rotate them a tad. Right. I for the eyedropper. Make sure everything's filled correctly. Let's see where my neck is. Yeah, I knew that was gonna be a problem. Straighten out just a tad. Let's get an ending in this arm here. I put way too much work into this one frame, which you'll see for not even a second of the game. I need to stop doing it. There we go. Alright. I'm done playing with that. Alright, not mad at it. Alright, let's do this one now. If you're going to be in the New Orleans area on November, I think it's the 29th, 30th, and December 1st, is that the right days? Let me make sure. Yep, 29th, 30th, and, wait no, that's not right. 30th, 1st, and 2nd. I lied to you. I will be at the WizardCon in New Orleans. Drawing and actually probably working on sketches for this. Last year when I was there, I actually kind of designed the new Riley, what I'm working on now. I mean, he didn't change much from his original design, but that's when I took the time and decided I was gonna make him look a little different. And it's pretty cool working at the con, because you get to meet new people, some pretty interesting people. And I look forward to doing it again this year. Hopefully I get to meet some more fans, if I have any. So come on out if you're down here. Yeah, I guess that would be right, because it would pull it back a little. So I'm not mad at that. Get a little steamy up in here. So let's. This should actually come up a little bit more. This hand something. Oh, nope, his hand's staying in his pocket. Alright. Not a big deal. So, all I gotta do for that is close that off. Lock that up. Cool, and move this over here, like here. Probably do this. Fell asleep. What's gonna happen here is him twisting his pocket the whole time. Shoot some. That was a long song. It's just ending right now. Mm-hmm. Yes. What happened to my buttons? Kate brings up your fill bucket. Anybody's wondering? S brings up your I want to call it your line, your stroke button. It's the thing, like, if you have a fill, you can add a stroke to it with it. That is the S key. I hate this commercial. It's for one of those audiobooks called Fancy Pants or Bossy Pants. So sick of hearing it. That looks pretty weird. What did I do there? Let's re-add that. Save that. See how it looks with the face and everything. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna have to take the neck off and give it its own get the neck its own layer, which I really didn't want to do, but it'll make things easier later on. So let's block all this out. What I'm going to do here is close the shirt off. So I'm giving you a layer, the neck its own layer. Let's get rid of this. And just name it neck. F6 cuts your, inserts a new keyframe. So we're just going to get rid of all these keyframes, or I'll just keyframe. And then we're going to reapply this. So right here, he looks down. Let's move the neck. He's moving it. The shirt's fine because the jacket's going to cover it up, so we don't have to worry about that just yet. Might later. See how this looks. Yeah, see, that works too. And we can pretty much keep the neck the same for those two as well. As long as things are covering up, I really don't care. Just gonna cheat this a little bit. Can stay the same. Alright, might as well finish up the neck since I'm here. I'm doing this in F5 to do this little number. Since he's a cartoon, I could stretch his neck. Alright, next done. We'll for that till frame 60. That's what I want to do. Let's do a little test move really quick. See it in real time. That looks pretty good, actually. Make it smaller. There we go. All right, let's continue with the jacket. I think I might be able to leave this. Sleeve alone. Maybe I can't do that. I was really hoping I'd be able to just leave the jacket alone. But it looks like I'm gonna have to edit every single piece of it. Bollocks. Whoa. Where's the green for his color shirt? See if I can do something here. Might work. Let's see. This might actually work. I'm gonna stop recording because I think if I go too long is when it starts to just shut off. So peace out.